That's good nasty. That fan needs a documentary. Chalkline needs to release that Arn Anderson jacket.
Don't forget tonight, great action on WCW Saturday night. Arn Anderson and
Bunkhouse. Ming with the high and tight.
Against the Stars and Stripes.
It is wild how many guys. Hey Terry Allen, we got another hour, buddy. Where it's not just the last 10 minutes. We got another episode after this. Mistook Ming for Victor Pinones. What was I gonna say? I got distracted. Maybe. Some noise in the background. But no, it's wild how Jimmy Hart got away with just like changing one note in his WWF songs and using them in WCW. Like the Nasty Boy song. All he did was change like the pitch a little bit and then had them put lyrics over it. Otherwise, it's their WWF song. Man, Buckhouse Buck had the best job. Didn't have to cut his hair, didn't have to brush it. There are days he didn't even have to shower before he went to work.
Taking them out of their brawling tactic and doing some Arn Anderson type of wrestling. There you see Buckhouse.
Like, that is the hair of a man battling depression. Like, if you put Bunkhouse Buck and like a button-up collared short-loose sleeve shirt and like some tight like skinny jeans, he would look like the guy who was fronting a band that opened for the Strokes in like 2003. Jimmy Hart did work on the music for Legends of Wrestling. Oh.
See, that ain't gonna get it done. Bunkhouse Buck, that ain't gonna get it done for them right there. Nasty Boys,
if you always liked Bunkhouse Buck. When you take a 10.5, he was perfect at being Bunkhouse Buck.
That'll get your attention. And that's
like, I don't think you could have a better Bunkhouse Buck than Jimmy Gold.
Nice high hip toss by Knobs. Brings his man up full scoop slam on Bunkhouse Buck.
Oh, you totally could. Totally should do that. And yeah, it's wild when Arn Anderson is by far the most well put together man in a tag team. Like, he looks like he showers. So that puts him ahead of everybody else. And then, okay, Adam brings up Dick Slater because he teamed with Bunkhouse Buck later on. Dick Slater looked relatively clean doing that gimmick. So Dirty Dick was kind of like calling a big guy tiny. No smegma on that, Dick.
It will be indeed Stars and Stripes against Arn Anderson and the Bunkhouse Buck. The World Tag Team Championship.
You do hear Gordon Soley. It's Gordon Soley, Dusty Rhodes, and Larry Zbyszko, who are dressed for different shows and appear to be calling different shows. Man, imagine Arn going from the Horseman, where you would have to spend like four figures on an outfit every day, to the Stud Stable, where you could spend half the day in bed and then wake up, go to the arena, and be the best looking guy in the group. Big fan of Arn Anderson's like one little tuft of hair blowing in the wind as Rob Parker's batting the hat around. Terry Funk was part of the Stud Stable. He was on his way out at this point. That's why he's not here. Painful Rash. There's a few teams that probably should have been called Painful Rash.
Well, they certainly want to take an opportunity right now with a quiet spot in the match to wish Billy Standridge the very best next year in NASCAR Winston Cup competition.
I love that we're just stopping the match to be like, hey, NASCAR driver, good luck. It was not even WWE's NASCAR period. Gordon Soley's just picking a random driver who probably like met him at a bar And he's like, hey, if I write down my name, would you like talk about me on TV? Yeah, sure.
To get it to go their way, but brother, they have still yet to take the brawling tactics of the Nasty Boys.
Hey, it's a CudaBucks 87 just subscribed. Thank you. My heart is full of love. I appreciate you. And I apologize for the ad breaks for those of you who are not able to hear me right now. I'll apologize again in a second. Trying the ad stuff. I have it, like, scaled back to, like, the least amount of ads possible. Again, those of you coming back, I apologize for the ads. I have it scaled back for the least amount of ads possible. Oh, jeez! Oh! While also having ads, so I could make a few bucks. I also, yeah, I know the ads suck, so I apologize.
Let's see if he goes to the three-quarter. No, sir.
Gordon Sully is like, will he put him in a three? It's a Nasty Boys match. He's not going to put him in a three-quarter Nelson. Oh, jeez. It's for ads. Like, doing bits? Like, haha, I'm wearing a funny hat during that? I mean, I can do that. I can find a funny hat. Oh, what's a package of some kind? Look, he cradled him. I guess that looks like a. See, I don't. If I knew how to do that, if I knew how to give bits for watching ads, I would. I'll look into it. I'll look into it, Cajun Jerk. See, that's a good idea. I need to reach out to some of these old toy companies. Be like, hey, I'm running your stuff. Do you, like, PayPal me a few bucks? Yeah, you could snark at any ad you want. Oh, I'm sorry. That sucks. The Twitch ads, the Twitch apps aren't crashing after ad breaks off to it.
I hear that many times. Four eyes are better than two.
That's a good point. Yeah, let's make this whole thing an MLM. I'll be at the top of the pyramid. And then I'll be giving out bits to all of you, and then you all give bits out to people, and the next thing you know, Louboutin. It looks like there's about 100 people in that building. It is so dark.
Arn Anderson slips into the ring now, closing in on Knobs. And so the Nasty Boys have got their problems.
Brian Knobs wrestled like a bear. Not like a talented bear or a coordinated bear. Just like a bear that was like awake at a campsite and was mad. The faces are the Nasty Boys. Believe it or not. I always love when a heel runs babyface corner and they make the tag and then he's like, wow! Like a gust of wind.
And so.
Also, he just whipped him by the suspender. Like, that's actually kind of dangerous to be wrestling with loose suspenders around your, like, head. That thing's gonna whip around and the buckle's gonna, like, hit you in the face. He did. Mongo McGuckle did wrestle like a bear. Womp womp womp. But really, he did. He did not wrestle like a human being. And that's why we love him. That's why we love him, really. Oh, Bob Parker almost bumped. Ming wearing his cut-off dress shirt. Man, we need to bring back cut-off dress shirts. Hell yeah, Ming.
Colonel Parker in trouble now. Ming has really messed things up here.
Ming has really messed up things here. Of course, Brian Knobs wears the head sideways.
Here on
Ryan Knobb should have been with the stud stable as like the drunk. The town, the village idiot.